motherfuckers be swearing their little bad. They know basketball, man. Sit your freaking tail down. Sit your freaking tail down. You don't know what you're talking about. Always going to criticize. Sit your freaking tail down. Sit your freaking tail down. You know what you're talking about. Always try to slide through. Sit your freaking tail down. Sit your freaking tail down. Always try to see the light when the light ain't even green. Sit your freaking tail down. That's your man, the myth, the legend. No, legend. The lift, the man, the myth, the legend. The hell I mean, legend. Your man, Urban Lover, coming from your mama's Urmobile because she don't want to pay the bill and kick me out the basement, but it's all good. I'm in your hood, a hood near you. Not your hood, because your hood might be scarier than mine. I'm just joking. Anyway, the freaking Atlanta Hawks. They thought they were going to fly, but they forgot it's South. Well, South. No, that's Miami. Anyway, they try to fly, but they didn't fly the right way. Instead, they got shot down. I mean, I'm just going to keep it real, man. Atlanta Hawks. I mean, they, you know, there's an up-and-coming team, man. They built it. Mr. Young, God dang it. You know, he started off slow, man. The defense smothered them the whole first couple quarters, man. But he wanted getting it going, man. He ended up with 31 points, you know, but a lot of it was trash points. But he kept his team not in contention, but he, you know, kept them relevant, you know, here and there. I mean, they had their little sparks of runs, but those runs was soon apprehended by the freaking, I can't even say twin towers, but the triple towers. You know, JaVale McGee, man, you got to give him hands off, man, in the first quarter. You know, if you look at his stats, they don't really show up too much. He only had, like, what, 7 rebounds, 2 points or something like that? Yeah, 7 rebounds, 2 points. But he had, I mean, just him being very active around the rim was a blessing. He had a couple blocks, a couple steals, well, and a lot of steals also led to him like knocking the ball away, getting them out on the break and all that. So kudos to JaVale McGee because, you know, he don't really get that much playing time. And a lot of fans, you know, quick to criticize him. And like I told you, one thing about it is that when Dwight Howard's not having a good game, we got JaVale McGee. Then you got Anthony Davis. And like I said, also with Anthony Davis nursing that his shoulder, I think his rib, if I'm not mistaken. It, you know, it allows, you know, by us blowing teams out, it gives them time to, man, really, you know, to sit back and just be on the bench and nurse a little bit longer. You know, when you got people like Dwight and JaVale McGee playing pretty good, and then you got Kuzma. But like I said, it's the Atlanta Hawks. But, hey, a win is a win. We're not going to knock it. You know what I'm saying? We're going to take it for what it is, man. You know, we riding on up the ladder, baby. You know, we doing what we're supposed to do. You know what I mean? Win freaking games. You know what I'm saying? And LeBron James, man, put me in a hyper chamber with that dude. Goddamn, what are you, 45? Moving like that? I ain't curse. No, you try to curse. Say, that's not cursing. Okay, I don't want you to flag my videos. But, man, at the end of the day, LeBron James, my goodness, man. Father Time hit him 2 times in the head. Bah-bah! Hit him so hard his daggone head gone. But now, you know, look at him right now. Man, this guy moving around like some of the guys, young and him, can't even move like him. Man, guy, oh, my God. That green through to him. You know, that nice little lob. Oh, that was nice. And also with Green catching that rebound and putting it back in, I woke me up out of my sleep. I woke up. I ain't even had no drawers on. I don't know what happened, but goddamn, I was so hyped. Let me stop. Let me calm myself down. Anyway, they played pretty good, man. I know y'all been beating on KCP. KCP has been delivering. The Lakers, as a family, are telling that guy, look, don't worry about the crowd. Shoot, man. And I want to also talk about the KCP thing. I'm going to drop a video. I don't know, but I'm going to drop a video later on down today or something like that. I want to get a little bit more in detail with the KCP because I know a lot of you fans are hating on them and stuff like that. You pick and choose who you decide you want to beat up for at that particular time because, yeah, sometimes, you know, we're human. You know, we're human and you're vowed to make mistakes. But in this society, you can't make mistakes in everybody's eyes. You know, we make a couple mistakes. Oh, we got to get rid of them. Got to trade them. Got to do this. Got to do that. Man, look, at the end of the day, we winning. That's all that matters, man. We winning. You know, I mean, what else can you ask for? You know, we doing our thing. Okay, Rondo, shout out to Rondo. He bounced back from a bad, poorly game that he played the previous game against the Kings. He bounced back. Had a good game, man. Dropped 17 points. They left him over. Made a couple threes. He started off kind of slow at first. You know, made a couple turnovers, this and that. But you should expect that. Even as a veteran, you know what I mean? You got to think about it. Come back from nursing injury. So, you know, and you're playing with a whole different roster of players. So, after a while, you know, you got to work yourself back into the rotation. And for those who keep saying that Alex Caruso won't get no playing time, you know what I'm talking about. Turn the page. Turn the damn page. Because this individual don't know what he's smoking. Turn the page. Alex Caruso, man, getting playing time, looking good, man, getting more comfortable playing with LeBron James. I think he had, what, 10 points? You know, man, the guys, listen, where's Cook at? I know, Cook's on the bench. And don't get me wrong, I like Cook, but Alex Caruso does a lot more, man. He plays pretty good defense. You know, he has a pretty much, he has a, you know one thing, man, the guy has a good IQ. You got to give him that, man. you know, when to put his body in the right position for charges and all that, man. You know, he's played, you know, he's not the best defender, but he's a smart defender. You know, so, yeah, that's why he's getting playing time. Plus, he don't have to play the three down to the one. You know, and that's why he's getting on that floor more. You know, and that's why you don't see the likes of Dudley. You see it Cook a little bit. You know, they try to get Daniels going because he's still nursing, I think, the ankle or something like that. But they try to get him going. But at the end of the day, man, like I said, is that the Lakers, man, shoot. The only team that can beat the Lakers is the Lakers, man. And once they really get the fundamentals of learning the playbook. Something's on my mind. I got to get it clear. But anyway, as long as they get to learn the playbook, they're going to be a hard team to beat, man. And I'm not saying because I'm a Lakers fan. It's just because I'm watching. Frank Vogel is doing good, man. I mean, like, here's the thing that people fail to realize about Frank Vogel that Lou Walton didn't do. Well, Lou Walton didn't handle backup. Frank Vogel has backup from Jeannie Buss and them. Frank, they telling Frank, listen, you go out there and coach that team. Don't worry about LeBron James and them. You coach the team the way you want to coach it. And at the end of the day, you know, whatever happened, we're going to back you up. Because, you know, you got Kirk and Linda, you know, as his support system. And they're good friends with Jeannie. That's why Jeannie said, we're going to run this system. As, you know, this still is a Buss-led organization to LeBron James and his camp. So Vogel has much more say-so than Luke Walton did. And that's the thing. Luke Walton had no backup because, remember, Luke Walton was Mitch and Jim's, young student. But Jeannie Buss, the Vogel's coming in on the strength of Jeannie and the Brambis, you know, Kirk and Linda. So, on retrospect to that, he's able to take LeBron James out. You know, because remember that one time LeBron James got pissed off and he took him out. And he put him back in, like, later on. But the point is, Vogel has that power to do that. He's not going to get fired. You know what I'm saying? I know this kid is there as a backup plan, but that's part of LeBron James' camp. But Vogel is part of Linda and Jeannie and all them. So he's getting the opportunity to do what he want to do, man. Take people out, rotation. I like it. Don't get me wrong. I mean, yeah, he only had like one bad rotation, but I like it. You know what I mean? He's actually allowing the guys to play, giving them playing time, working what he think is best. And right now we're 11-2 right now. You can't ask for no more, man. I'm happy. I'm excited. You know, like I said, Kyle Kuzma is looking pretty good. You know, he's getting his game going. You know, and that's about it, man. You can't really talk about it, man. Like I said today, Atlanta's an up-and-coming team. Mad respect to the dude, young man. You know, he's keeping his team in contention. But, you know, they still got a lot. They still got a big hill to climb. But they're going to get there. As long as that dumb Atlanta organization decide not to trade their players. Like they always do. They give up too quick. You can't keep giving up on your players. You got to develop your players and allow to build around them. Especially when you got good quality players, man. Don't be a fool. Look at Phoenix Suns. You know what I mean? They stuck with Booker. They ain't trade him. And look at them now. They're playing pretty good at the beginning of the season. I like that. But anyway, it's your man, Urban Lover. Like, share, subscribe, get in the comments, and tell what you think. You already know what it is, man. This is a short video. Ain't too much to say about the Atlanta game. You know what I mean? We went in there and did the thing. We bust off the birds, you know, got shook off their feathers and all that. I don't believe in Thanksgiving, but now y'all got something to cook for Thanksgiving. Bye-bye. Y'all take care. Have a blessed one.